Hey there, it's Kristen with K Design Co, and today I want to walk you through how to add a gravity forms form to your Showit website. So this will only work if you have an advanced blog plan with Showit, but it is incredibly worth it because gravity forms is a super powerful form tool, and I use it on not only on my own website but on tons of my clients' websites, and the extended functionality that it has is been such a game changer for so many reasons. So I will put a link to Gravity Forms in the show notes, but what you're going to do is going to go to gravityforms.com, and then you're going to purchase a license. So this is a paid plugin, but for $59 a year, like I'm saying, it's super worth it. You can get drop down functionality, conditional logic, so many integrations that they have with email marketing services, CRM services, and like I said, it's just worth it. So you're going to purchase a license subscription for your business. And then once you have purchased a subscription, then you're going to go to your licenses page and you are going to come and get your license key. And then you're going to download your file for your zip file. So you need the license key copied to your pasteboard, and then you need to download your file. So once you have those two items, you're going to come over here to your plugins, and then you're going to add a new plugin on your WordPress dashboard. Like I said, you have to have an advanced blog plan and show it to be able to upload your own plugins. You're going to add a new plugin and upload plugin, and then you're going to drop your file, install. Now with some basic setup, you just have to click the activate button, and then once you have your button activated, you'll see that it is now installed. And so once you have your form installed, you can go over here, pull down this little toolbar, and now you'll see you have this little guy over here called Forms. So you will be asked to enter a key for your form under the settings to activate your license. You'll paste that right here. I already had this Gravity Forms installed on this site, so that's why I didn't have to do it. But make sure you go to settings, add your license key, paste that in here, and then you scroll down to save your settings to activate your license. Then what you're going to do is you're going to create a new form. So let's say we're going to make just a basic contact form. So you can type in your title, hit create form. And then right here, you're going to be allowed to add any form fields that you want to your form. So this is like kind of a drag and drop situation, and you can have up to one or two columns. And then you can also even get fancier with some like pre-built in classes if you want. But for the most part, it's pretty drag and drop. So you'll see all of the field options are over here available to you. So we have the kind of like standard fields, just like basic form fields, drop downs, checkboxes, radio buttons. So these are all types of form fields that you are not able to get in Showit. Showit just has the basic text field. So this is why it's a really great add-on tool to create those more robust functional forms. So what you're going to do is you're going to create all of your fields that you want. So like, let's say I just want a name field here. You can go ahead and add that. And then once you click on the field that you've dragged onto the page, you can just give it any sort of label. So we have that. And then let's say I want to go back to my fields, just click the add field tab again. Let's say I want to have another field called website. So again, click on the field and then go to the general tab to give it a label. And then let's say I want one more field for a larger, like a message. So I click the paragraph text, and then I'm gonna say this is called message. So these are all just the labels. So we did that. And then you can go through, and each field also can kind of have some additional settings to it. So let's say name is gonna be required. We're actually gonna make all of these required. So over here on the checkbox, if you just keep scrolling down, you'll see the required option. So that's pretty easy to do. And then if you collapse the general tab, you'll also see under appearance, there's another set of options that you can do for this, each of the form fields. So one that I like to include is placeholder. So you could include a little placeholder message here. So you can do that for all of the fields if you want, or just some. You can also change the field visibility if you want, where it's aligned and or if it's shown at all. You can also have a description for each of your fields. So if you wanted to, besides having a placeholder, if you wanted to have a description, that would show up wherever you designate. So first and last name. So if you wanted some additional information, that could show. So you can see right now by default it shows below, but you can change where that shows up by the appearance tab. So if I go over here, so if I say above inputs, then it will get changed to above. So you can see there's some basic kind of options for formatting. You can also change the size of the field by default. If you want like a shorter option, you can always click that. So once you've got your field created, or all your fields created, and you're happy with the way it looks, then you want to go ahead and save your form. Now, once you have your form saved, you're going to want to do a couple more things before you head over to Showit. So one of those being setting up your confirmations and or notifications. So confirmations are what somebody will see on the screen after they submit this form. So you always want to kind of tailor that message. By default, there is a confirmation kind of already set, but if you want to personalize that, you just kind of go in here and update the text here. You kind of have basic formatting capabilities and put whatever you want. So once you've updated the confirmation, then you're also going to want to set up a notification. So a notification is what you will receive to let you know that somebody has filled out the form. So you can customize this as well. Just go to edit. And then you can tailor the fields here to what you would like to see. So by default, it's going to put the administrative email associated with your WordPress setup is where these messages are going to go. So if you want it to go to a different email, you can do that. I would recommend though that whatever email you put there, make sure that it is one that is associated with your domain. So to ensure deliverability that you're going to get those notifications. So if your website is at mydomain.com, then you want to make sure that the email is also at mydomain.com. And then you can put either who it's from, the from name. So that could be from your website, or you could say it's actually put in the person's name who wrote you the message. You can use these merge fields. So you could put the name right there. From email, again, this is a deliverability issue. You want to make sure that you include a domain that is associated with your website as well. So whether that's info@mydomain.com, or you could even also put in your same email. So it could be to and from the same email technically. And then the reply to, I always put the person's email address in there. So again, you could use the message or the merge tag field. I didn't have an email address in this one, but easily you could add that. And then down here, by default, it will print all of the fields that somebody filled out. But if you want to tailor the message or add your own little twist to it, you can do that again here as well. And then you're just going to update your notification. So now that you have your updated notifications and confirmations all set, now you are going to create a page inside of your WordPress. So you're going to go to page, and let's say we're going to create a new page called form, contact form. So once you have that, then you're just going to go here and click the little plus button, and then you're going to search gravity forms. Then after that, you're going to select your form. You're actually going to see a display preview of your form, not the styles, but just kind of a bare bones wireframe version. And then you can actually click on this. And then if you want, you can turn off the title if you don't want that to be shown. And then you're just going to say publish. So now we have a new page on our WordPress that's called contact form, and it is published. So The next thing you're going to do is go here into Showit, and you're going to want to make sure you have that same page created for your Showit side of things. So what I'm going to actually do is duplicate a page on my template here. This will work no matter what template you have for Showit. So let's say I'm going to duplicate this, and I'm going to call this contact form. So this page design is going to merge with my WordPress form that I just created. So I call this contact form, and then you need to go over here to template info. Make sure you're clicked on contact form, and then you should see template info right here. And then instead of WordPress template page, I'm going to go down here to custom, and then I'm going to write the word page with a dash, and then I'm going to write the slug of the page I just created. So page dash contact dash form. So then I'm also going to double check that when I click on this box here, that it has a text property applied of post content. So post content is applied. So that basically means whatever content is in WordPress, that is what content is going to show inside of my box here. So I'm also going to double check that this says post title. That will make sure that whatever my title of that WordPress page is fills in this area. So now that I have that, I'm going to go ahead and publish. And I'm going to wait for that to tell me it published. Okay, so now I'm going to go over here to my test page. And now we get to see if it worked. It's the fun part. So now I see my contact form page, my title fed in here, and I have my two fields and my message field. So awesome, it looked like it worked. So now by default, you're going to want to probably tweak the styles, and usually this is done with CSS for things like the buttons and the form field design. Even if you don't want to tweak, it will pull in the styles of your site typically as far as the fonts go. So there you have it. If you have any questions, feel free to drop them in the comments. But hopefully you find this helpful. Please subscribe and like this channel. Thanks.